Outpour East here, Outpour Outdoors. And today, I want to show you guys what I brought out for this wild camp. I didn't bring a backpack. I actually have a bedroll, and I have kind of like my food bag. It's a canvas food bag made by Campcraft, and just a haversack. I want to start the video by saying a lot of people are going to try to rationalize this, and I kind of understand that. A lot of times when I post things, especially like my haversack loadouts, all types of stuff, people are like, oh, you should take this, you should take that, you should take this. Let me stop you right there and say, try not to rationalize it too much. This is pure recreation for me. I'm not a survivalist. I'm not claiming to be a expert bushcrafter. I pretty much just come out here to have fun. I know that a lot of people take this way more seriously than I do, which is completely fine, and I look up to those people, but I don't take it that seriously. I come out, I have some fun, I'm with my brother, another buddy of mine, we cook some steaks and we have a good time.
So I'm gonna do a plow point off of this tree.
I just wanna show you what I got with me, because I think it's pretty neat. So without further ado, let's take a look at it. I'm gonna show you how I got it packed too. And the way I was wearing it, it actually feels like a backpack. It kind of like carries like a backpack. It's a hotter day today. I think it's about 60 something degrees right now, but I had to bushwhack my way in here pretty good. So that's why I have my jacket on. It's gonna get 60s, low 60s, high 50s tonight. So, and I could also use this as a pillow. Let's actually start with just what's on me, what's in my pockets. Today I'm rocking a LT Wright Legom. It's an awesome knife. That's my fixed blade, Scandi blade. And I have a Glock 10 millimeter, it's a Glock 20. I know some people don't like guns. If you don't like guns, that's okay. Don't carry a gun. I got a lighter in my pocket here. This was actually sent to me by a buddy of mine. Thank you so much. You know who you are. He watches the videos. Thank you so much. He made me this cool little thing. It's kind of like a poor man's Exotac. Has like a little thing there that goes over it and some duct tape. Pretty sweet. Got a big old ferro rod that I could put on my belt. I got some duct tape on that. It's in my pocket there. Just my truck keys, my wallet, and I think that's about it. Yep, that's about it for my pockets. Oh, I have a Benchmade Griptilian. It's great for food. It's the knife I carry every day. Jimbo, if you're watching, thanks for sending me this, man. I really appreciate it. So that's what's in my pockets. And now let's go to my haversack right now. So in the haversack right now, it's just a Pathfinder oilskin haversack. Up here, I just have a bandana, and in that bandana, I have some toilet paper wrapped up in it. I got my compass here, which is just an MC2, and the pouch is, people love to ask me about my pouches, so I'm gonna try to get better about mentioning that. This is a Coalcracker Bushcraft pouch that matches, which is pretty sweet. Just got a t-shirt, so I'm not sleeping in a sweaty t-shirt tonight. My journal, a lot of stuff that if you guys are around the channel, you're gonna see over again. This is my my tool roll, which has become a staple in what I carry. And in the tool roll today, stuff changes a little bit, but it usually stays the same. Got fish mouth spreaders to hang a pot, a sharpener, a chisel, a spoon knife, a Sharpie, and a little Swiss Army knife here, which I don't remember off the top of my head. It might be a Ranger. I don't remember off the top of my head what kind of Swiss Army knife that is, but got that knife from my brother Jimbo too. He's a super awesome guy. Then I got a little hatchet in here, a little Holzbrook hatchet. Some cordage and stuff to set up my ridge line. I've spoke about it in other videos, how I set up my ridge line. I'm not gonna go into it in depth, but I use these night eyes. It just sets it up so quick. It's awesome. A headlamp, a black diamond headlamp. My fire kit. I'll show you what's in it real quick. I got some of these Bigfoot Bushcraft fire starters, which are awesome. Some fat wood, a flint and steel, and some char cloth in there. I'm trying to go quick, because I don't want this video to be too long. And I just got a Baco Laplander. Little piece of cotton for maybe signaling or whatever, and some batteries wrapped in some duct tape. Moving along here, I'm going to show you what's kind of in the food bag here. We brought a couple steaks out. So my buddy Mason's pack has the steaks. This is just a canvas bag that I got from Camp Craft Outdoors. And in here, I got a couple canteens. There is a creek down there, but we couldn't get to it. This is the first time I come to this spot, so I didn't know if I was gonna have a water source. So I brought two canteens of water, which I'm happy I did because it's kind of hard to get down to that creek. So this is the Pathfinder canteen set, the TI set, the full TI set, and then this is just a second canteen. And here I have a little pouch here that has a spoon, some more food, some oil, some seasonings, and an extra lighter. Got some cough drops at the bottom of that too. Here I have just some lotion, some juke twine, some bank line, and a little first aid kit. It has some band-aids, some pills, a tourniquet, and just some stuff like that. Not a crazy first aid kit. And then in here I have a little pouch that I made out of some oil skin. I sewed this pouch together. It just has a little toothbrush in it and some toothpaste for the morning. Here I have some coffee and some honey. I don't know what this pouch is. I don't know where I got it. Got a little bit of coffee, which I have to refill that. Now I have some honey in there. Got a bag of tea. Some Carmex, the lids for my little cups there, and a Lixedia, the weird band-aid, a Lixedia titanium can.
This looks good. A little like overdone, but kind of hard to gauge when you're not using a stove. It's delicious. It's crazy because, so check this out. Look at that, like cooked with titanium, right? And come check this out. This is cooked with stainless steel. I'm sure everybody watching knows, like, you know, the difference, but. Man, like, this is not even, like, I mean, you can just see, like, it's not, like, searing like the other one did, and it tastes, like, way longer. On the same fire, same oil, you know. Just crazy how hot titanium gets and how quick it gets that hot, you know. It's just nuts.
Okay, now to the bedroll. I tried to keep it pretty simple. I'm gonna have to clear some of this out just here. So the bedroll is held on with this pretty cool, it's kind of like an axe sheath, but we'll get to that right now. It's just held on with some clothesline. This is like some cotton clothesline that I get, that I really like because it doesn't stretch a lot. And I wrapped it in that, and it's actually what I would use for a ridgeline, which, like I said, I don't think I'm doing a ridgeline tonight. But I might. You never know. Sometimes I start doing things and I have to change my plans. So this is my ridge line. And it already has, it's like prussic knots on it. And everything's all set to go up when it needs to. Let's show you the bedroll here. So the bedroll is made by Bushcraft Spain, and it's wool on the top, and it's oil skin. It's supposed to be oil skin, but it doesn't feel very oiled. I've had tarps from Tentsmith. I've had tarps from Coal Cracker, and they all feel very oiled. This one doesn't feel very oiled. I'm not sure if all their tarps feel like that. But it doesn't feel like the quality is, I'm not ragging on them, but it doesn't feel like the quality is like, definitely not like Tentsmith. And it doesn't feel like the Coal Cracker quality as well. So I'm not sure if I got an anomaly or something, but it doesn't feel like it's the best. Just throwing that out there. I can make another video about it, but it's pretty cool. But for the price, I don't know. I got it in a trade. I don't know if I would buy it. Just being honest with you guys. So there's what everything's wrapped in. Up here, just got some work gloves, which I'm about to put on to clear all this stuff. And I got some pretty heavy stakes here. And then the shelter that I'm rocking today is going to be an 8x8. And it's a Tentsmith 8x8. This tarp has been really good to me. I actually set it up in like a semi-permanent shelter on the homestead in the winter, and it did pretty well. I was going out there with my daughter having day camps a bunch, and I mean, it held up great. It still feels really nice. It's not as oily as when I got it, but it still feels really good, and it held up really great. So in here I just have some gloves just in case I get cold at night, some wool socks, a beanie, and a towel. And then I have the pump sack for my sleeping pad. So it's not like it's not fully traditional. Like, it's kind of like a traditional and modern kit. But I could go fully traditional, but I feel like I would be a little bit more less comfortable, and I don't really know if I want to sacrifice that comfort tonight anyway, so I just didn't. And then I have a Swagman roll. This is I forgot who makes these, to be honest. Is it Helicontex that makes these? Yeah, it is Helicontex. So Helicontex Swagman roll. I have a Sea to Summit Aeros pillow, the large. And then I have a Thermarest NeoAir X-Therm, which is the sleeping pad that I use year-round. So that's it. That's everything I brought. It seems like a lot less, and a couple stakes. I do have a couple stakes in my buddy's bag. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. One thing I forgot to show is my saw. I did bring a saw with me and I keep it in this pouch. I think I got it from the Amazon. It's a pretty cool pouch. It can you could put an axe in the front here, but it's when you, it could hold like a 19-inch axe. But today I brought a little hatchet, and the saw that I brought is a Boreal 21 folding saw. Actually, Eric, can you hold that so I can? And the way it works is you just fold it out like that. It's a great saw. I've been using these for 2 years now. I have two of them, and they work great. Forgot to mention that. And we're gonna be out here for tonight, and we're gonna try to scout, see some other spots in the morning. And of course, the video has to have a plane in it, you know, and I'm gonna leave it in there. So yeah, I'm gonna roll in some footage of when everything's set up, so you guys can kind of see us cooking and see what we get into. So thanks so much for watching, and I can't leave you without praying for you. I want to tell you that if you're going through a storm right now, if life is hitting you kind of hard, just know that life is a life of seasons and seasons change. So right now I pray peace over your mind in Jesus' name. I pray serenity over your mind in Jesus' name. I pray a peace that doesn't even make sense. Like right now you're having peace and you forgot about everything you're going through and you're like, wow, that doesn't even make sense. That's Jesus. I pray the Holy Spirit comes into the room wherever you are and just fills you with joy and happiness. And just know that whatever you're going through, I've been through a lot. I've been through addiction. I've been through divorce. I've been through stuff that I just thought that I wasn't gonna make it out the other side. But here I am, you know, and everything worked out. And just know if you need someone to talk to, you can hit me up, outpoureast @gmail.com. And I wouldn't mind speaking to you, man, and just chopping it up with you. If you're a veteran, salute. If you serve in the military, salute. Whether you're active or not, if you serve at any capacity and in public service, I just want to salute you. We salute the police here, we salute the firemen here, and anyone who serves in a capacity like that. We love you guys. God bless you guys. Thank you guys for checking out the channel. See you.